بسم الله. طيب so last class we stopped at this example, so we'll go over it again. So in this side we have our module of the circuit. This is the circuit that we saw a few slides back. There was an AND gate and an inverter. The output of this inverter is signal Y, and then an internal signal E is going into an OR gate. So this one will be E OR Y. Okay, and this will give us X. In terms of delays, the AND gate has a delay of 30 time units. The inverter has a delay of 10 time units, and the OR gate has a delay of 20 time units. Okay, so to build a stimulus for the circuit, we will write another module. We'll call it stim circuit. To define the inputs and the outputs that we need to write to and read from, each input in this circuit will be defined as rig ABC, as a rig. طبعا هذه ال signal names can be anything. It doesn't have to be ABC. So we can write rig X, Y, Z, and we can write wire AB. Okay, that's, it doesn't have to be the same name. ولكن ال inputs, you have to declare a rig for each input. I have three inputs here. You need to define three rigs. And for the output, to be able to read these values, after you apply the inputs, you will declare the outputs as wires. So we have two wires and three rigs. طيب, after you define the rigs and wires for your inputs and outputs, you need to make an instance of your model. So we will write the module name, circuit with delay, and then this is the instance name. This is any name of your choice. And then between brackets, you're gonna either write these signals in in order, يعني تكتب A, B, C, X, Y, أو input, 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 output, output. So this is input, 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 output, output. أو إنك تستخدم ال dot. So you can write dot A, dot B, dot C, اللي هي عن طريق port name. And then you can write dot y and dot x. Okay, so these, after, right after the dot, this is the port name of your module. Inside, you're gonna wire whatever you have in your current module. So for this one, it's gonna just go as A, B, C, Y, and X. استخدام البورت نيم does not require order. ولكن if you're gonna use order without port names, you have to follow whatever declaration order that was in the module. Okay, الآن التستمنت جاهز for you to start choosing values for the input. So inside an initial block, we're gonna go initial begin and end, and in between you can write يعني whatever cases that you wanna test. Okay, so you're gonna be applying values for all the inputs that you have, and then you can watch the outputs. So at the beginning, remember that when you simulate, everything has to be يعني in order with respect to time. So at the very beginning, at t equals zero, just at the start of the simulation, we're gonna set the value of the inputs as 0, 0, 0. Okay, so it says A 1 bit 0, B 1 bit 0, and C 1 bit 0. Here, this command is wait for 100 time units. So at t equal 100, what's gonna happen is the value of هنا خلينا نكتبها هنا A B C equal to 0 0 0, At t equal 100, ABC should go to 1 bit 1, 1 bit 1, and 1 bit 1. So that's 111, and then wait for another 100 time units. After that, finish the simulation. So at t equal 200, end the simulation. Okay, and you applied these inputs, and we want to check the value at the output. So what you do, or what the output of the simulation should look like, is a timing diagram that looks like this. Some Verilog simulators require you to write extra commands. I'm not sure if you guys do that. Fi command ismu dump vars. This is something just for the simulator to dump your file or dump your signals and dump all your signals in يعني file. ناسي والله الكوماند dump vars, and then I think you need to give it a file name. I don't even remember the extension. But if you're if the one you're using after you simulate just give you the timing diagram, that's fine. Otherwise, there are some commands that you need to write to give you a file, and then this output file should be read by another program. Okay, so anyway, the output of the simulation is going to be a timing diagram. So let's check our signals. في البداية قلنا إنه ABC, this is ABC, and then this is X, and this is Y. Okay, so ABC at the beginning are set at 000, and then at 100, we change this value to 1, 1, and 1. طيب. بالنسبة لX and Y, Y is an inverter. Y is an inversion of the value of C. So, بما أنه بدأنا at 0, C equals 0 at T equals 0, المفترض أنه Y goes to 1 متى at T equal 10. ليش؟ لأنه عندي 10 unit delay. Let's check. So here the value of y, طبعا كانت unknown at the beginning. When you start the simulation, you can decide the value of the input. ولكن before that, any value of the output will still be unknown until you apply some input. So when we applied 0 after 10 nanoseconds, which is here, طبعا هذا باعتبار انه this code chose اللي هو time scale 1 nanosecond and any precision. So this should be using 1 nanosecond because this chart is in nanosecond. Okay, so at 10 nanosecond the value of y became 1 اللي هي عكس c. Okay, so this delay is working perfectly. طيب, تعال عند X. For X to change, you need to pass through the AND gate, which takes 30 time units, and an OR gate, which takes 20 time units. So the total has to be 50 time units. So whenever there is a change in A and B, that will cause a change in X, this should take 50 nanosecond. Okay, so take a look. A value of X here. See, it didn't take that much time. Because, okay. A value of X تتأثر بطريقتين, يعني عن طريق E أو عن طريق C. So after 10 time units from the beginning, this one changed to 1. Okay, هذه 0 and 0, this result in 0. So after 10 time units, this became one, and this is an OR gate. So after 20 time units from that, you're gonna get X as one. بالتالي 10 plus 20, that's 30. Check here at 30. So each one should be four. Okay, كل واحدة 4 time units. So 24, 28, sometime in here, that's gonna be the 30. Okay, so at 30, X went to 1. طيب بعد كده الـ inputs ما تغيرت until we reach 100. At 100, we change the inputs to 1, 1, and 1. Let's go back to the inverter after 20 time units, or after 10, معلش, after 10 time units, about here, this value changed from 1 to 0. Because your input now is 1, so after some delay, which is 10 time units, this turns this value to 0. طيب. I'm gonna draw the circuit again. (10, 30, and 20). So this was initially 1, and then it went to 0. So after this has gone to 0, an input at X can 0 من هنا, and now it's can 0 1 والآن صار 0 0. فبالتالي X should go to 0 after 20 time units from this transition. So at 130, X will go to 0. Okay, and then how the change, this change caused this change, and this change caused this change. صح إنه A and B went to 1, 1. A and B is 1, 1. بالتالي this is 1. بالتالي X should be 1. ولكن considering the delay, هذه ال 1, 1 متى راح تأثر على ال output? After 50 nanoseconds. So that's why it dropped here to 0. بعدين مع ال 1 1 هذه تعال ل 50. This is 140 nanoseconds. So this is 50. At 50, it goes back to 1. Okay, so these two caused this change. Once you verify that all your circuit is working as expected, that means your simulation is and it has passed. You don't need to do any modification in your circuit. Usually what happens, and no, after you simulate, let's say you simulate this circuit and then this signal never went to 0, for example, attack straight line here. You know your module and you're expecting your module to work in a certain way, and this is not the behavior that you're expecting. So what you do is that you go back to your code and check for errors, either in your module or maybe something that you did in your test bench. ولكن الأغلب إنه المديول في يعني the module has some errors. So in general, if you have any module, I think we have a slide for that. So there's another example in the slides. We have this circuit. هذا الاكزامبل بس انه هنا. Yeah, so this is another circuit عندنا. This module, is this an AND gate? Yeah, that's an AND gate. So, ولكن عرف الAND gate in Aulus block. يعني مشوار صراحة ما أدري إيش الفائدة. Okay, so for an AND gate, if you are building your own AND gate, you can write input X and Y, and we have one output trig if, you're going to use behavioral modeling for that AND gate, and you assign f equal to x and y. Your input, you want to do all combination of input. We have x and y, so we want to do 0, 0, we want to do 1, 0, you want to do 0, 1, and 1, 1. It's like testing all cases of the inputs, and your expected output is to stay at 0 until the input is 1, 1, and you get 1 at the output. There is no delay, I think. Can you do a delay? Okay, هنا ما أضاف أي delay in the gate. Okay, so let's move with the slides and see what's the purpose of building this AND gate. طيب, in your test bench, بالنسبة للتست بنش, we're gonna make an instance of your module. So this is your AND gate. You have two inputs and you have one output. So inside your test bench, you're gonna make an instance of that, and you're gonna define two rigs, one for X and one for Y, and one wire for F. And then in the procedure from in the initial In the initial begin end block, you will just change the values of X and Y to test and check the value of F. So this is a test bench for this AND gate. We're gonna define the inputs as rigs, that's X and Y, Y for F for the output. Here, we make an instance of our AND gate, passing the inputs and the output. And then here, he's gonna be testing all the combinations of X and Y. So we start with 0, 0, wait 10 time units, make it 0, 1. After 10 time units, make it 1, 0. After 10 time units, make it 1, 1. طبعا لاحظوا انه هذه time delay in Verilog can be written anywhere. وما تحتاج إلى سيمي كولون. فهنا أعتقد كل واحدة كانت في السطر. أي. This was in a separate line. Here. No, it was just written يعني right away. Okay. You can do it even after the semicolon. يعني whatever makes you feel comfortable, you can just write it anywhere and it's gonna apply to the simulation. Okay, so after applying the last one, you're gonna wait 10 time units for the output to compute, and then we will finish the simulation. Okay, so we used 1, 2, 3, 4. That means your simulation should run from time t equals 0 nanosecond up to t equal 40 nanosecond. Why nanosecond? Because we define the time scale as 1 nanosecond. And the allowed times, you can use S for seconds, MS for milliseconds, US for microseconds, NS for nanoseconds, PS for picoseconds, and FS for femtoseconds. Okay, usually we go with nanosecond or microsecond. For يعني, small gates, this works in nanosecond. And this should be the output of the simulator. Okay, check X when started at 0, after 10 time units went to 1, after 10 time units back to 0, 10 time units went to 1. And Y started with 0 for 20 time units and then 1 for 20 time units. That's why it looks like this 0, 1, 0, 1. Y is 0, 0, 1, 1 as you defined. And then note that this is the time in nanosecond goes from 0 to, we should stop at here, which is 40 nanosecond. Okay, and this is if give you all zero except when the input was 1 1, it turned to 1. طبعا لاحظ ان ما استخدمنا او الموديول ما في اي delay, فبالتالي you get no delay at the output window. Once this is 10 to 1 and this is 1, you get 1 at the output. طبعا usually يعني it's recommended انك if you're working on a circuit and you're required to do some ان يكون فيها يعني كل جيت له delay معين, انك في البدايه تلغي الديلي هذا and you simulate the circuit to make sure that without delay it's working, unless your circuit is based on يعني a design that has يعني مبني على delay of a certain gate. يعني مثلا عندك if this is x in this way, so this circuit will not work unless you يعني give some delay unit to these inverters to make y goes يعني تعتبر clock generator in some way or another. ولكن if you have يعني if your circuit is based on delay, you have to add delay. ولكن if you're testing just a normal combinational circuit without feedback, you should simulate it without the time delay first. طيب, here we have an example of they want to build, what did they call it? Key-ish. A built-worn signal. Built-worn اللي هو التنبيه التنبيه لربط الحزام. تمام, so we have, this is giving too much details that we already know, لكن باختصار شديد أو built worn example, عندنا three inputs and one output. هي الفكرة إنه this circuit should control the LED light in your car to give you a warning if the belt is worn أو if it's off. تمام, ف turn on the warning light is when W equal 1. معناته إذا من طلبت الحزام W should equal 1 and this is going to the LED signal in your car making يعني يعطيك الإشعار إنه الحزام يعني مو مربوط. تمام, so turn on the warning light when W equal to 1. If, what are the condition? If the key is in ignition, معناته المفتاح في السيارة. Person is seated, P equal to 1. This is coming from a pressure sensor in your driver chair. And seat belt is not fastened, where S is equal to 0. So simply, you need an AND gate for K and P. Low if key is in ignition, person is seated, this is going to be an AND gate. And then, not this is the same circuit again. Except that we need an AND gate here to give us the W signal. Okay, so your key has to be in the ignition and you need to be seated. This will make this one. And if the belt is not worn, تمام, we want to give a warning that the belt is off. Okay, this is simply the circuit. They wrote the module in structural behavior. We're going to build, استخدمنا ال AND gate that we used. You can also use the primitive. They built also an inverter. And an inverter, I think a built-in primitive is not inf. I'm not, is it? Let me just, I remember, شباب, the built-in primitive for the inverter, is it env or not?
Not.
So probably they made another module for that. This is a waste of time. Where is it? Yeah, okay. I think they wrote another module for inf. Anyway, it doesn't matter what you use. Well, like in Finiha, we need two AND gates and one inverter. So this is two AND gates, and we have the inverter, and we know how to write this. You go with output. And two module that he created is input, input, output. Same for the inverter is input, output. بالنسبة لي built-in primitives, لأ. It goes as out and then the list of inputs. Okay, that's why it's written here. Otherwise, don't get confused. These are written by the user. It's not the system built-in primitives. Anyway, so you write the description of the circuit. You use N1 and N2 as wires. And then, here's the inverter. This is the inverter. One input, one output. Output rig. And then F is equal to not X. Okay, so he's using the AND2 module that he defined the last slide. And then this inverter to build this built-worn module. By the way, we want to write the test bench. I think all the information in this slide, we already talked about how to define, how to use the module, instantiation. We already done all that. Okay, so this is how you write the test bench. You start with defining the time scale. You want to do it 1 nanosecond, 1 nanosecond. We have three inputs. So these inputs will be defined as rigs, K, P, and S, and one output, which is W, that's going to be defined as a wire. Make the instance, use the module name built-worn, the name of the instance, this can be anything, and then K, P, S, and W as it appears in your definition of the module. Okay, you go by order or use the port names. There you go, initial, begin, end. Then you just write the value of K, P, and S and start testing. So this is, it started with 000 and then 010. Here you are testing 110 and here you are testing 111. You are giving 40 time delay between each step and the other. So that's going to be 40 nanosecond of total simulation time. Don't forget to finish your simulation with the dollar sign finish. And this, I don't think this is correct. Okay. Yeah. I'm not sure if this is even here. طيب, for test bench, يعني, as a block diagram, it looks like this. This is our instance of the module, and then we pass the value of KPS and read out the signal out of the wire W_S. Okay, so the output should look like that. 10, 20, 30, and 40. So you have 0, 0, 0, and then 0, 1, 0. That's 110 and 111. Let me check the value of W. So if K كانت for the key, P for pressure, يسموها. المهم هذه اللي هي person present, ايش كان اسمه السيجنال؟ Person is seated, okay? So if key is not in ignition and the person is not seated and the seat belt is off, the value of W should be 0. Then the circuit looks like this. And this is an AND gate. So this is K, P, and S. and we get out of that the value w. Okay, so this is correct. Now check for 010. If the key is not present, this is 0, this makes it 0, this makes it 0. So right away from K010, this should be 0. Now, for these two cases, I have the key in ignition. So your car is on. In these two cases, also the person is seated. Okay. So if the belt is not worn, السيارة شغالة وانت في مقعد السائق, فبالتالي if seat belt is off, that means I should give you the warning that this will turn on the LED light, giving you a warning that your seat belt is off. If the car, if the key is in ignition, person is seated, and the belt is already worn, so we need to turn off the light because we don't need it anymore. Okay, so this confirms that your functionality of your circuit is correct. Okay, all these slides in between is just any details that we already talked about, how to make an instance. This is what we talked about in the beginning of this unit. Okay, using a wire and using the rigs inside the behavior, this is all things that we know before. That's why I didn't go through these details. Okay, but I can, when you study, just go through it, make sure that you understand that you don't have any questions about the content of these slides that we skipped. Okay, we are left off with user defined primitives and the forever loops. I'll just do it next class. We're gonna stop here. And inshallah, next class, يوم الثلاثاء, we will solve the homework.